I'll discuss the solar connected, grid connected inverters, direct motivation, direct feeding of solar PV to the main grid. We are assuming that grid has infinite source or sink capacity. Advantages are no storage required, cost per unit is less. Battery, yeah, battery is one of the most expensive component there, and life of the battery is, of course, lead acid battery, they say not more than 2 to 3 years also. High operational life requirement is connected to the main grid. Disadvantages, in case of grid failure, what next? Because the moment if there is a grid failure, from the DC side, there is power coming, continues to come. So handling, one has to detect the grid failure and take appropriate action at the inverter side. That we need to see. Okay. See, what are the major categories of inverter? There is one central inverter, high power inverter. Rating could be of the order of 100 to 500. Okay. String inverter, what do they mean? We will see. Medium power, 3 to 20 kilowatt. Module inverter, 50 to 500 watts. A very favorite question of NIT Calicut. Okay. And multi-string inverter, various DC-DC converters, high power, common inverter. What exactly? These are the various categories of inverter. What exactly are there? We will see. Central inverter. See, various PV modules are connected in series to form a string, something like this. There are n number of solar PV panels in one string, and there are n strings. Okay. And they are connected directly to the inverter, and inverter to the grid. High power inverter. Okay. There are n solar panels. What is that n? We will see. Okay. In series, and n such strings directly to the inverter to the grid. Okay. Various such things are connected in parallel. Central inverter converts this DC to AC. Okay. Only error level of monitoring is possible. High and efficiency is slight higher. Why? Efficiency of this inverter, because it is a high power inverter. So if you take, for example, efficiency of a 1 kilowatt machine and efficiency of a 100 kilowatt machine. Okay. So efficiency of a 100 kilowatt machine is much higher than efficiency of a 1 kilowatt motor. Similarly, efficiency of a high power inverter is much higher than efficiency of low power inverter. So that's what it is. So various configurations are here. Directly output power from the solar is being fed to the DC capacitor. Who does this? MPPT sets. Now the reference DC link voltage is being set by the MPPT. Okay. There is no DC to DC converter here. There is no DC to DC converter here. These solar panels are directly connected to the inverter and to the grid. This inverter could be, yes, either 2-level or 3-level or whatever multi-level inverter that you all are talking about. There is an LC filter to filter out high frequency components here. See, the high, as the power rating increases, you have to reduce the switching frequency. The moment you reduce the switching frequency, the frequency of the predominant harmonic that is present in the output voltage also comes down. Okay, and that has to be filtered out. You use an LC filter. In addition, there's a transformer. Transformer has the leakage inductance. So this L, it forms an LCL filter. It forms an LCL filter. Okay. So the various features are here. The PV array voltage VDC is directly controlled by MPPT algorithm. The operating point of the string is determined by the MPPT. Typically, DC link voltage is of the order of 450 to 820 volts. Okay. So when the output voltage is when the DC link voltage is 450, inverter output voltage line RMS would be of this order, 450 by 2, 1 over root 2. This will give the RMS value of the phase voltage, RMS value of the phase voltage into root 3 is the line voltage, 0.98 is being the modulation index. Okay. Now here is the VDC reference is being set by the MPPT and remaining control will remain the same. What is the remaining control algorithm? VDC reference is being set by MPPT and it will change as the solar insolation changes, this will change. So what the inverter does, takes actual voltage it monitors through a PI regulator, determines output is the delta. The remaining control will remain the same. Only difference is MPPT is this reference DC link voltage is continuously changing. This is the second topology, the so-called multi-level inverter. Multi-level inverter. The philosophy is the same. Maybe as the power level increases, there are advantages of going in for multi-level inverter. Okay. Because for a same switching frequency, my harmonic spectrum is superior here. Rest remain the same. Yeah. Central inverter. Yeah. What are the limitations? Only 1 or 2 MPPT algorithm for the full array. Okay. For the full array, there are hardly either 1 or 2 MPPT regulators. Panel-wise MPPTs may not be possible, so it may not be possible to handle the shade and other issues. Okay, and reliability, 1 point failure. What happens if the inverter fails? What happens? Because entire power is being handled by the inverter. Entire power is being handled by the inverter. If the inverter fails, yeah, there is no power transfer at all. The second one is a string inverter. Same concept. Now, I said this is N. Here, maximum could be 6. 6 to 8, that's what the literature says. Here I said N, because the power rating of the inverter is of the order of 100, 300, that's what it says here. Power rating could be 100 to 500. His power rating is 3 to 20 kilowatt, 3 to 20 kilowatt. Therefore, I need to reduce the number of panels. So this N could be, parallel N could be 6 to 8. To realize high power capacity, many strings can be installed, modular design, okay. One maximum power tracker for few strings. In case of failure, only partial power feeding capacity is lost. Okay. I said there are large number of string inverters. Each string has 6 or 8 strings have 1 inverter and there are N inverters maybe. So if one inverter, something happens one inverter, part is lost, now the entire capacity as the previous one. What are the various challenges? As the power rating comes down, efficiency, trying to maintain the efficiency is going to be an issue. Okay. Low cost and compliance to standards. What are exactly the compliance standards we will see? Okay. It's not only the harmonics, the amount of DC current or DC current to the ground, these are the issues we will see. The string inverter, single phase topology, one such topology I have shown here, okay. Thyristor based, thyristor, when I am saying thyristor, it is basically an ideal switch. Your entire inverter size will reduce. Why? My gate drive requirement has reduced tremendously. There is a significant reduction in the gate drive circuit because I need to have only pulses that I will transfer to the power side using pulse transformer, whereas gate drive of a BJT, MOS or an IGBT, they require continuous gate drives. So those continuous gate drives cannot be transferred through a pulse transformer. Of course, if you are using a pulse transformer, then you have to suitably design it. It may be a bit difficult. Generally, opto isolation is used. The moment there is an opto isolation, there is a transistor there, it requires biasing voltages. I will just show you the complexity that is associated with the MOS inverter or IGBT inverter. Just see here. Gate drives to this inverter device is being, sorry, gate drive to this device is being applied with respect to its source, with respect to source or with respect to emitter in BJT. So reference point is source. Okay. The potential of this reference point for a phase A, phase B and C is continuously changing. It is not at a fixed point, whereas the reference point for the lower devices is the same. Since this potential of the reference point is changing, in other words, reference potential, the reference point is floating, I can't use one common power supply for all of them. So therefore, I need to have a separate power supply. Again, I need to apply positive as well as negative gate drive. So I need to have plus, I need to have plus 15 volts or minus 15 volts, assuming that is a MOS or a IGBT. Again, plus or minus 15 here, plus or minus 15 here. And one common power supply is sufficient for the lower devices. So I need to have four power supplies minimum for the power circuit, and again a couple of circuits in the control side. So the number of power supplies and therefore the overall gate drive circuit, size of the gate drive circuit increases. Whereas in an SCR, in case of SCR, though this potential of this point is changing, I need to just apply a pulse, sharp pulse, only during turn on. Only during turn on, I need to provide a pulse that I will pass through a pulse transformer, and I will directly go to gate and cathode, because I have a series of high frequency pulses that I can transfer using a pulse transformer. So there is a, from output of the pulse transformer through a diode or something like that, straight away can go to the gate. Sorry, I have to redraw it. I didn't change the paper. Can I have, see, I will repeat this SCR. Though the cathode potential is changing here in a DC to AC converter, this requires only pulses to turn on. Okay, so that I will transfer it through a pulse transformer, and they can directly go, of course, through a diode or whatever, through to the gate. So there is a significant reduction in the gate drive requirement, and therefore the gate drive circuit. So in other words, SCR is almost an ideal switch, except that it does not have the gate, does not have turn off capability. Now, if there is a grid available in a single phase case, I can have a very simple inverter. The moment I use an SCR, it is one of the most reliable switches compared to others. Okay, so this is the power circuit configuration. I have a solar panel. This is nothing but a buck boost converter. See, the conventional buck boost converter output voltage gets inverted. I get a negative with respect, output voltage negative with respect to the reference point. Conventional buck boost or chuck converter. If you have forgotten, go back and see. Okay. So that's what it does here. I'll turn on these two switches. Current builds up. Open it. Current flows through this diode. Charges the capacitor. Okay. There is an inductor here, and these are the fourth thyristor. What is the control strategy? The duty cycles of T1 and T2, they are varied sinusoidally. Why are they varied sinusoidally? I'll just tell you. See, we want the current fed to the source should be sinusoidal. I'll repeat, current fed to the source should be sinusoidal and it should be in phase with the voltage. It should be sinusoidal and should be in phase with the voltage. Okay? That is the requirement. I need to have almost a sinusoidal current. So what do I do? If this current through L2, if it is has a waveform of half wave rectified sine wave, full wave rectified, if see something like this, I'll show you. See this here. This is the current. Somehow I have to make the current through the inductor looks like this. Inductor current should be a full wave rectified sine. If this is the current flowing through the inductor L2, and if I turn on appropriate two thyristors in this zone, this is the current fed to the grid, which is almost a sinusoid. How do I ensure this sort of a current through the inductor? I can ensure this sort of a current through the inductor by making the duty cycle of S1 and S2 vary sinusoidally. How do I do that? I'll take full wave rectified sine, compare it with the triangular wave, okay, and the pulses I will use to control T1 and T2. So these are the pulses through the boost inductor. The triggering pulses, the gate pulses for T1 and T2 are generated using a full wave rectified sine. That sine is in phase with the source voltage. Okay, that I can do using a step down transformer and zero crossing detector and all. Okay. And compare it with the triangular and generate pulses. Therefore, the current through the inductor, it looks a triangular wave, linear increase, linear decrease. Inductor current is discontinuous. This inductor current is discontinuous. So if I have that sort of a current, L2 will have, by suitably choosing L2, current waveform looks something like this. If this is the current waveform, current fed to the inverter single phase grid is a sinusoid. Okay? Yeah. So this is how it works. T1 and T2 are triggered using the grid voltage, rectify it. Okay, step down, rectify, compare it with the triangular wave, turn on off here. This current is a triangular wave. Use a filter to get a sinusoidal current in the positive of trigger T1 and T4 and T2, 3T in the negative of feed the power. This is one such configuration, and second such configuration is here. Same thing. The duty cycle of IGBT, that is this, is determined by comparing the rectified gate wave with the sine wave. Whatever that we have done here. Yeah. That's about it. So what are the limitations? It's very obvious here. See the peaks here. These are all discontinuous pulses. Peak is of the order of 25 amperes. And see the RMS value. RMS value is low. So peak current through T1 and T2 is higher. Okay. So therefore, and moreover, I require a large size of L2. Okay. Yeah, this is all we are. I already overshot by 5 minutes. There are string inverters topologies, the transformer list, suppression of common mode noise, leakage current. There are various issues I will discuss tomorrow. Tomorrow is last lecture. We have 2 hours. We will discuss in those. The overall, the other grid topologies, what are the issues? Okay. Can I replace this electrolytic capacitor? Can I have a different current source topologies? And finally, can I have a small DC grid itself? In other words, instead of having that inverter supplying my loads, I'll have a DC grid feeding the load, that we will see tomorrow. What is this, one second, Surat? See, there is a question from Surat. If I want to implement MPPT technique, where I implement, converter side or inverter side? A difficult answer. If there is an inverter as well as a if there is a DC to DC converter and inverter, generally duty cycle is the MPPT controller generates a duty cycle for the DC to DC converter. If there is a only single stage conversion, then there are issues like what I already showed you. Where is the DC to DC converter here? There is no DC to DC converter here. So it depends on the circuit topology. Depends. If there is a DC to DC as well as DC to AC, generally MPPT algorithm, MPPT decides duty cycle. Sir, maybe know the current and future research related to solar energy. Oh, I don't know. Maybe know the current and future research. Maybe know the current and future trends in solar. My sincere request to you is, as the secretary or minister or my views also, let us not get bogged down with the research. Let us try to design a reliable inverter which rural people can use. A reliable inverter, cost effective, reliable inverter. Or can you have a different school of thought itself? Okay, why we have to do DC to DC and DC to AC for what? I don't know. Everyone, if you see the literature, everyone talks about, they'll try to modify the DC to DC converter, they try to modify DC to AC converter, do some jugglery and do something, which somehow it is not acceptable to me. So I would like to refrain from answering this question. The DC link reference charges the MPPT charge. Kya? How to make the DC link? No, you mean in this circuit? Yes, it does change. It does change. The DC link reference changes as MPPT it changes. How to make the DC link constant? Who said DC link constant? I never said that. DC link, actual DC link voltage should be made equal to the reference. Please, VNIT, N, whoever has asked this question, try to understand. Actual DC link voltage should be equal to the reference. Now the reference is changing. So if the reference is changing, DC link also has to, actual DC link has to change to make it equal. Okay, as the DC, if the DC link is increasing, for a given modulation index, output also will change, isn't it? Come on. If this VDC is increasing because VDC reference is increasing, for a given M, output of inverter will increase. In other words, this voltage is increasing. If the grid voltage is constant, this current will increase and therefore power. I never said that. What I said was actual DC link voltage should be equal to the reference. That's all. If reference is changing, DC link also has to change. That's all. In solar panel, shall we use Z source? Hey Bhagwan, yes, you can. You can. And you may be able to generate a paper or two, but then that will not go. My sincere request to is, whatever that I said, try to make a more reliable inverter. Z source inverter, there are papers, yes. Answer is yes. Output of inverter can be controlled by controlling M and VDC. Can we obtain reasonable performance by controlling either M or VDC? What do you mean by reasonable performance? Output of the inverter can be controlled by controlling M and VDC. So generally both are not advised. You do, either you keep VDC constant and change M. Because as if VDC goes on increasing, you have to choose the devices accordingly. Because the inverter devices have to block the DC link voltage. So if you allow the DC link voltage to change, so devices you have to choose the devices for a worst case. So you may have to choose a higher voltage devices, therefore the cost also will increase. It's up to you. and I don't know what exactly you mean by reasonable performance. You can get a good performance using both. Oh, what is that, Trichy? If in string inverter topology, one, though pulses of the buck boost in converter vary sinusoidally, why not the output capacitor charges to the peak voltage, which in turn causes direct current flow? No, 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 it is not a very high value of C. This value of C is very small. NIT Trichy, this value of C is very small. If you see the capacitor voltage, it completely discharges. It is also a triangular waveform. If the capacitor is not completely discharged, it may affect your this current waveform. Why? See, you have to go back and analyze the circuit. So this inverter transfers all the power here, all the energy, and capacitor is completely discharged. This is a small value of C. If you choose a higher value of C and if there is a finite voltage, your current waveform will deteriorate. I have not discussed the design issues. There is a literature, it is also available. Okay, if you want, I can send the paper. This value of C is very small. It does not maintain a constant voltage. Please see here. This is the capacitor voltage waveform. Charging, discharging, completely discharges. Sir, what are the issues if we connect an inverter with square wave output to the grid? That you need to tell, sir. Why square wave inverter? Why do you want pulse width modulation? You tell me. Why are we doing pulse width modulation? Why not just connect to the square wave? Yeah, if it is a three-phase square wave inverter, what is the frequency spectrum? 5th, 7th, 11th, 13th, all odd harmonics, 6n plus or minus 1 harmonics are present. In a single phase, all odd harmonics are present. If the grid can take it, you feed it. If the grid can't take it, then of course you will not be able to. I have not said that inverter cannot be, square wave inverter cannot be connected to the grid. If the grid can take those harmonics, you go ahead. The moment you are feeding power to the grid, it has to satisfy certain standards, and standards may not allow you to connect a square wave to the square wave inverter to the grid. Can I connect output of PV inverter directly to you? Connect, do what? Can I connect output of PV inverter directly to single phase grid in my house, though power meter will save some units?
Sir, is it possible to save some units?
I don't know, sir. Do you have such metering this one? Assuming that you have a very good inverter feeding power to the grid, grid can take it. Do we have such a metering? It has to read the, in a sense, if you have all those facilities, yes. I don't think as of now it is possible. Can your meter read that?
Sir, if there is a reactive power in my home, a reactive component load, then meter considers it. No, so why not my inverter power?
Sir, I don't know, what do you mean power meter considers it? Power meter, that is energy. Now you tell me, your energy is equal to power into time. Power is V into I into cos theta, average power into time. So energy meter reads active power. It will not consider reactive power. How can a power meter consider this reactive power? I don't know.
Sir, current flows, sometimes current is negative in power meter.
What do you mean the current is negative in power meter? It's the AC current, no? What do you mean the current is negative?
That means out of phase. Out of phase with the voltage wave.
How is this out of phase? This means this is V and this is I. Reverse power flow, who is the, your load is
that
generating
is power. That is a.
How is this possible?
That means feeding the power, sir.
Now, this is feeding the power, I know, but how is this possible in your home? That I am asking you. This is possible, I know. This is feeding power to the grid at unity power factor. Feeding back the power to the grid at unity power factor, but aapka ghar mein kaisa ho raha hai, wo humko pata nahi hai. Thank you.